Hello, my name is Burcu Sarı. I'm the CVI Project Coordinator at CVI Center at Perkins. In this video, we will talk about sensory integration. What is sensory integration? Sensory integration refers to the processing, integration, and organization of sensory information from the body and the environment. In this assessment area, we look at visual skills when other senses are used. Research says many individuals with CVI have difficulty using their vision in noisy, crowded, and cluttered environments while looking and listening, and simultaneously implement motor movements. How does sensory integration impact vision? Individuals with CVI can struggle to establish and maintain visual attention when presented in other sensory inputs, or in an environment with lots of sensory stimuli. Sensory integration requires an ongoing assessment. On this slide, we have a photo of a little girl sitting in a shopping cart in a store. She's covering her eyes with mask while holding the side of the shopping cart with one hand and putting her finger in the mouth. Some individuals with CVI may have difficulty maintaining visual attention when there is a familiar or unfamiliar sound in the environment, when they are physically challenged, or when they are being touched or moved, or when they are feeling motion or vibration, or when they are touching materials with different textures. On this slide, we have a photo of a little boy sitting down and looking away while touching and feeling a big size blue textured ball. It might be difficult to use his vision while he's touching, as we mentioned previously. Some individuals with CVI can use one of their senses, usually the stronger sense, at a time. Many individuals with CVI require that only one sense is challenged at a time. Otherwise, they can demonstrate reduced eye-to-object contact when looking or listening, or they might cry or have meltdowns in busy, loud, new environments. They might be repeatedly asking to leave the space. They might be frequently startled easily or become visually fatigued quickly. On this slide, we have a photo of a young man in a busy restaurant. He's crying while his head is tilted back. Some examples of sensory integration impact: working on visual tasks while listening to environmental sounds, such as music, TV in the background, or people talking in the room, could be very challenging. In other words, it could be distracting. So many individuals require quiet environments so that they can focus on visual attention and recognition. Another example is, some individuals with CVI might not prefer or like to participate in events or meetings due to having difficulties using their vision in larger or crowded settings or arrays, such as old school meetings, conferences, concerts. We would like to share some voices from CVI world regarding to sensory integration difficulties. A CVI mom says, "My child doesn't like going to loud places. He would usually cry or sleep when there is too much going on." An individual with CVI says, "I always hate going to old school meetings. It feels like everyone is talking at the same time. I can never see what's going on at the stage, although I always sit in the very first row." And here is the current research and literature that we have on sensory integration. Every child with CVI is teachable, and every child has a right to a meaningful and accessible education. If you would like to learn more about CVI or sensory integration, you can visit cvinow.org. Thanks for listening.